Hello and welcome to another tutorial on PSIM software. Have you ever wondered what happens if we have a capacitor filter installed as an output across the output of a rectifier system? In this video, we will try to visualize that the use of capacitor filter across the load in any kind of rectifier system, it produces peaky currents in the input side that are not very much desired in the power electronic systems, because they actually increase the ratings of the devices. So in this particular video, we will try to find out, first of all, we will find out that how we can visualize these peaky currents, what are the nature of these peaky currents. And then we will also discuss how we can find out the power factor of a rectifier system that contains a resistive load and a capacitor filter in parallel. So these two things will be discovered in the today's topic. So let us simulate the system.
Okay, let us simulate this particular half-wave circuit where we have I have created this circuit arbitrarily. With the source voltage equal to 169 volt peak, which means it is actually a 110 volt system with 60 hertz frequency. There is one diode available here, and the current is measured through this current sensor. Also, we have a capacitor here. I have used an arbitrary value of 1000 microfarad here with no initial capacitor voltage to show the concept of the inrush current. Also, we have this resistance available. I have considered a 50 ohm resistive load here. The whole system is actually simulated for a total of 0.1 second. So let us simulate the system. So once we have the simulation available, let me bold the different waveforms here so that they are more clear to see and to visualize. So now I have drawn almost all the values here. So you can see here the VC. This VC is actually, you know, charging up to this particular point here, after which you can see here that the IC becomes negative. And this negative IC means that the capacitor is now supplying the current to the load. So during this period of time, when we have the diode turned off, you can see that this voltage is not available across the load. However, this capacitor is trying to supply the power to the load. Therefore, you can see here that the capacitor current is negative. Also, throughout the for the value, the IFR stays positive, and that is actually a result of the combined action by the supply and the capacitor. So you can see here during this particular time when the diode is turned on, it actually follows the envelope of this input AC waveform. Thereafter, it follows the traditional curves as seen by the first order circuits consisting of an R and C. Also, we can see here during this first half cycle. So let me just get rid of this IC here, and I just need to elaborate here the voltage across this VC here. So you can see here that for this particular value of this VC, so the VC actually gets the current right after the application of the positive half cycle, during the first positive half cycle when the system is first energized. So during this particular period of time, you can see here a huge amount of current actually is inrushed into the circuit, the value of which can be seen through this particular global maximum. So if you see here, at this particular point, this IFS is equal to 63 ampere, which is a very huge amount of current. But once the capacitor is charged to some value, you can see here, now during the next half cycle, the capacitor is not starting from the 0 volt. Rather, it is starting from a voltage equal to 126 volt. So therefore, as a result, the source current is now reduced to a value that is equal to 43 ampere. So you can see that considerable difference can be seen for the first time that we energize a given circuit, and thereafter when the system comes into a so-called steady state condition. Also, if you can see here that the wave shape of the of the input current is not a sinusoidal value. Therefore, this provides a lot of issues with respect to the power factor. So you can see here, if I draw this V of S into I of S, and I remove the rest of the screens here. Okay, let me place the V of S as well here. So again, let me make it a little bit bolder to view. So now we have seen that if I find out what is the power factor here, then the power factor is, you can see it is 0.33, which is a very low power factor. So that is how we can actually simulate this single phase circuit. One more thing that you can try doing at home, try to increase the value of this capacitance and see what is the effect on the input current and its effect on the ripple of the output voltage.
I hope you have all understood this particular concept and you have enjoyed this video. If you want to comment on any aspect of this particular video, do comment here. I will try to answer that comment. And also, if you want to further explore any aspect of any kind of power electronic circuits, you can comment here. I will try to simulate that particular system as well. So happy learning, stay safe, take care.